In England, at the end of the 18th century, the European Industrial Revolution was born. Its repercussions were slowly pushing into the Lithuanian lands occupied by the Tsarist Russia and into Lithuania Minor, which was ruled by the Germans. The weak reverberations of the middle of the 19th century erupted by the end of the century. The sound of factory machines spread in Lithuanian cities increasingly rapidly, and the noise caused by a passing train, shaking the supports of newly built metal bridges, could be heard increasingly often. Industrialization affected the development of architecture. In Vilnius, Kaunas and Klaipėda, industrial buildings, distinguished by new reinforced concrete construction, began to be designed. The installation of electricity was a strong sign of technical advancement. The first power station in Lithuania was not built in one of the big Lithuanian cities. In 1892, Duke Oginskis built it on his estate in Rietavas. After 8 years, a public power station was built also in Kaunas. A power station in Klaipėda was launched the same year. In 1903, the Vilnius Central Power Station became operational. Its ornate exterior and a modern interior made it unique. Petras Vileišis, the famous champion of Lithuanian national pride, associated the development of industry with the country's economic and social advancement. The biggest changes occurred in Vilnius. In new residential areas, a newly developed middle class, including employees of different institutions, bankers and tradespeople, was becoming established. In Georgius Avenue, presently Gediminas Avenue, administrative buildings, banks and hotels were built. Other cities also tried not to lag behind. After the freedom of the Lithuanian press was regained in 1904, and after the revolution of 1905 in Russia, art organizations began springing up. In 1907, the Lithuanian Art Association was established, and in 1908, the Vilnius Art Association was founded. Artists spread throughout foreign countries, who afterwards returned to Lithuania for varying periods of time. They were attracted by the more active cultural life and maturing ideas of national art. They used to gather in elegant cafes and patisseries. Lithuanian cities changed. Architectural and artistic trends became different. Both more luxurious and more modest buildings of graceful forms started being built, and nicely illustrated books began to be published. More decorativeness appeared in artistic works, and craftsmen became busier. All of this showed that the trend toward the modern style, widely spread in Europe, reached Lithuania at the junction of the centuries. Modernism, which was a strain of Art Nouveau that was developing in the lands of Tsarist Russia at that time, had different names in other countries. In France, Belgium and a part of England, it was called Art Nouveau or New Art. In Austria and the Austrian part of Poland, it was known under the name of Secessionsstil. In Germany it was called Jugendstil, in Italy its name was Liberty and in Spain Gaudi. In the United States it was known as Tiffany style. Not only the names, but also the historically determined nuances of style differed in each country. In Lithuania the terms Art Nouveau, Modernas and Secesija are used to describe this concept. The definition of the Jugendstil emphasizing Germanic influence is often used when talking about the Klaipėda region in the west of the country. In Europe, the new artistic trend dominated from the end of the 7th decade of the 19th century until World War I. The style appeared as resistance to the academic and eclectic attitudes of the 19th century. It expressed a strong attempt at creating completely different art, which would eliminate the borders between fine arts, arts and crafts, and would stylistically create a unified living environment, bringing fine crafts and industrial manufacturing closer together. The origins of Art Nouveau reached back to the ideas of the British arts and crafts movement and the interest in Eastern, especially Japanese, art. The characteristic features of the style are special attention to the lines, the combination of stylization and naturalism, the decorativeness of images, and the presentation of symbolic meaning. Lithuanian artists could become familiarized with art and architecture of the modern style while studying in Paris, Munich, Krakow, Warsaw, and St. Petersburg. The new artistic ideas reached a wider portion of society through foreign periodicals and exhibitions held in Vilnius. In 1903, the Krakow Artists Association's exhibitions called Stuka Ars was held, and in 1918, a Munich Secession exhibition was organized. The newly established class of wealthy industrialists and bankers, who wanted to live in a luxurious and at the same time modern environment, actively supported the development of modernism. They not only financed new construction, but were also concerned about education and establishing new workshops for crafts. The banker Josepas Montvila is one of the best examples. In 1896 in Šėta, he established a textile workshop called Birutė, in which textiles of the Lithuanian primitive and English styles were woven. He also improved the Vilnius Drawing School's crafts department, which was headed by Ivan Trutnev, and established drawing classes there in 1904. He fostered underprivileged children and taught them crafts, founding charitable organizations for this purpose. Juozapas Montvila organized exhibitions designed for the development of crafts and the construction of houses. In Lukiškių Square in Vilnius, a unique complex of modern-style houses called Montvilos Kolonija, the Montvilos Colony, attracts attention to this day. Modernism included all the areas of fine arts, arts and crafts, but in Lithuania it was predominantly expressed in architecture, for the most part in Vilnius and to a lesser extent in Klaipėda and Kaunas. In provincial buildings it was also displayed. Usage of new construction techniques and materials determined the spatial solutions of modernist architecture and induced the search for new forms. The asymmetric composition of modern-style buildings and flexible ornamentation, which dominated in decoration, created an image of light and graceful buildings. It was the opposite of the heavy and solid architecture of the historicism period. Buildings were filled with small towers of different shapes, mansard roofs and bow windows. Motifs of chrysanthemums, water plants, roses, ears of crops and sunflowers, which were placed on walls and were often used in decorative metal gates and the decoration of gates and balconies, were popular in embellishment. Stoves made from special ornate glazed tiles, parquetry consisting of beautiful designs, and stained glass windows distinguished the more luxurious interiors. In painting, in addition to the realistic impressionistic and neo-romantic landscapes, unusual fantasy motifs began to be depicted. The themes of death, love and fatal women, which were characteristic of the fin de siècle spirit of the end of the century, grew popular. After turning away from reality, people became interested in aesthetics and began searching for the beauty of forms. In Lithuania, the modern style intertwined with other artistic tendencies, especially with symbolism, which encouraged artists to depict things that could not be seen and could only be felt, the metaphysical secrets of existence and the human spiritual world. Even nature motifs had meaning encoded by the artist. A blooming garden could have symbolized youth, and a wave in the sea could have meant the flow of history or the artist's restless life. New artistic techniques also began to be applied, free and sketchy brushstrokes, the soft portrayal of space, the attention to colors and to lines that became popular in the modern style, and attention to a decorative or flattened view. Mikalojus Konstantinas Čiurlionis distinguished himself from other artists. His works formed the context of high European artistic culture and expressed ideas that were topical at that time. A relationship between painting and music is revealed in Mikalojus Konstantinas Čiurlionis' works. Čiurlionis started painting his first abstract works at about the same time as the Russian painter Vasily Kandinsky and the Czech painter František Kupka. Symbolic content and a tendency towards the decorativeness in form, characteristic of the modern style, were illustrated in Ferdinand Ruščik's painting and the works of Adomas Varnas, Stanislavas Bohušas, Sieščenčevičius, Mstislavas Dobužinskis and other painters. At the junction of the centuries, there were not many local professional sculptors in Lithuania. Monuments and more ornate headstones were brought from famous Polish and Russian artists. The creation of realistic sculptures with elements of impressionism, symbolism and modernism showed in the works of Boleslavas Balzukevičius, Petras Rimša and Antanas Vivulskis. Modern trends also developed in applied graphic arts and the works of Mikalojus Konstantinas Čiurlionis, Petras Rimša, Paulius Galaunė, Vilius Jomantas and Adomas Brakas. A new wave of interest in crafts provided the impetus to create new and stylish works that were often enriched by folk motifs. However, the majority of works of applied art were imported from Poland, Latvia, Germany, the Czech lands, and other countries. Local craftsmen created plainer and less complicated modern works following foreign examples. Works that were unique or one of a kind were also sometimes produced. Petras Rimša's chairs and the carpets designed by Kazimieras Stabrauskas and Antanas Jaroševičius, for example. Modern features which began appearing at the beginning of the 20th century developed during the period of independent Lithuania, during the 20s and the 30s. Industrial architecture provided the basis for the development of constructivist architecture, and Art Deco artists extended the principles of modernism in fine and applied arts.